Hey there guys, thanks for tuning in to Dirt Bike Channel. I'm your host Kyle Brotherson and this is the 2020 Beta 200 RR. This is the full review, stick around. So I had to bring the bike back up into the mountains. This is kind of late season for mountains in Utah, but I had to bring the bike back up into the hills because that's where this bike is happy. That's where this bike is home. I've had the opportunity to ride this bike in mountain single track and desert stuff, in fast flowing stuff and tight technical terrain. And this bike actually shines in a lot of those areas in ways that I didn't think it could. My overall favorite thing about this bike is the motor. It's a 200cc two-stroke and it has just the right amount of low-end grunt and just the right amount of top end that this bike can go slow and it can rip. But what it will not do is it will not flip you on your butt. You can come out of a corner and grab a fistful of throttle and you can be okay. You can be going over like rock steps and you don't get whiskey throttle. Like if your weight gets thrown too far back on the bike and you end up getting kind of more throttle, it doesn't instantly loop out from under you. And that is one of the magical things about this bike, is it's the perfect amount of power, tractability, and playfulness all in one little package. I can't tell you how many times that I was going through certain obstacles and I thought, I'm not gonna have enough grunt here because I'm on a smaller bore two-stroke. And then to my surprise, the bike just cycled and powered and gutted its way through, much like a bigger bike, like a 300. But then there were other situations where I thought, oh, I'm gonna be kicked over onto my butt if my back wheel gets any hookup, and I didn't get flipped all the way over. So that's this perfect little balance of power and playfulness and capability. If you know very much about Beta, or if you've listened to my podcast with Tim Pilge, president of Beta USA, you know that one of Beta's taglines is rideability. Now, what they've been able to produce with this bike is an essentially amazing, rideable bike. This is now going to be one of the top bikes that I'm going to be recommending to people that are just getting into enduro riding and off-road riding. And that isn't to say that this bike isn't for advanced riders, because advanced riders can still have a blast on this thing too. But what they've done with this bike is they've created an entry-level bike that has the capability far beyond what most of the other entry-level bikes would have. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that this is entry-level, but what I'm saying is this is forgiving enough that an entry-level rider can get into this sport and have this bike and be able to ride this bike for many, many years to come, and it can kind of grow with them. These bikes are a little bit lower to the ground than some of the other bikes out there, some of the other manufacturers. So they're made about an inch, maybe an inch and a half lower seat height to the ground, and that makes it easier for a shorter rider to feel comfortable on this. And then just the things that they've done with the ergonomics, the way the foot pegs are, the way the handlebars are, there's a lot of adjustability in how far you're moving the handlebars around. There's multiple places on the triple clamps for you to move. I think there's six positions that you can put your handlebars, because there's three different holes in the triple clamps, and then you can turn the mounts around to customize this in six different ways. And what I'm saying is this bike is able to fit a wide variety of riders and make them feel comfortable. The thing about this bike is you can ride it very slow, or you can ride it very fast, and it seems to just be balanced. This isn't just a beginner bike that is not going to be any fun for the advanced rider, because it is fun for an advanced rider. I have a ton of fun on it. All of my riding friends have had a ton of fun on it. And the funny part is most of the people that I've put on this bike have gotten off it and said, you know what? I want to buy one of these things. Even though the bike has a little bit more of a compact feel to it, it feels more like about 7/8 of a dirt bike. I don't feel like I can't push it through whoops and things like that. The bike has this stable, planted feel that makes it a joy to ride. Another thing that is actually pretty surprising about this bike, it weighs a little bit more than some of the other bikes that I've been riding, but that's only on the scale. When I take it out on the trail, this bike feels as light or lighter than all of the other bikes that I've put it next to. So keep in mind that just because it might weigh a little bit more on the scale, that doesn't mean that it feels heavy when you're out on the trail. It certainly hasn't for me. Of course, this bike is electric start, which makes it nice. They do not have a kickstart on it from the factory, but you can get a kickstart kit to add to this thing, which is good for some of the hard enduro guys. The bike did come with a skid plate, although the skid plate does not cover the linkage down there, so that's a little bit of a concern for some of the hard enduro guys, but the Beta linkage doesn't hang down a lot as much as some of the other bikes out there in the field. It did not come with handguards. I had to put these handguards in on my own dime, so that's something to think about. There are no handguards on this bike. One interesting thing about the Betas is that on your right hand, on your right brake, you're gonna get a Nissan brake. On the left hand, though, you're gonna get a Brembo clutch. I would prefer if it was Brembo on both sides, but after talking to Beta USA President Tim Pilge, Beta has just stuck with the Nissan brakes. They say the Nissan brakes work fine, and they've stuck with that. So it's got Nissan brakes front and rear, which I think on the rear brake, I don't have a problem with it. The Nissan brake is fine. For me, I don't like the feel of the Nissan brake, the front brake, as much as I do like a Brembo or a Meguro brake, but it is serviceable and it does work. I just feel like the brake is a little bit grabby. What happens is I've got plenty of stopping power and I start to pull the lever more and more, and then all of a sudden there's like a breaking point, or there's kind of a switching point, a tipping point, where that front brake will grab, and I don't have that problem with some of the other braking components out there in the industry. So that is one thing to note about the Beta brakes. The Kian carburetor that comes on these bikes is bulletproof. It is dynamite. It's probably one of the better carburetors out there in the industry, at least that comes stock on these bikes. With a little bit of playing around on the jetting, I was able to get this bike so it runs really, really well. It probably had to take the tank off a couple of times to swap jets around. So once I did that though, and I'm riding the bike between, you know, 6,000 feet and probably 8,000 feet is the highest, well, 8,500 feet is the highest that I've had on the bike. And I've been able to find a nice sweet spot with that carburetor, and it makes this bike just run pretty buttery smooth. These Beta bikes are all basically wired up so that they could go street legal. So you've got a headlight, you've got a tail light, you have signal, it's wired for signal lights, and they have horns on them. So I don't love all that stuff on these bikes, but you do have that. Another very cool thing about the Beta is the trip computer. This trip computer is one of the best trip computers that I've seen on any stock bike. I'll tell you why. It has trip one and trip two, which is pretty common in the industry, but it also has timers for trip one and trip two. So you can reset four different things. You can reset your trips and you can reset your timers, which is really interesting to me. So it will tell you how long the motor was running for that particular trip. And I'm a numbers guy, I'm a numbers geek, and so I like that. I wish more bikes came with that. So the trip computer on the Beta is a real plus for me. These Beta RR standard bikes in 2020 come with an open cartridge front fork set. And this fork set is actually very, very good. In all the terrain that I've had it in, the bike just tracked straight. I never felt like I was wondering what the front wheel was gonna do. And they've improved this a lot in the last few years. One of the Betas that I had recently was a 2019 Beta 390 RR race edition. I think I prefer the forks on that race edition to these when I'm pushing it hard, but when we're just going slow through the stuff, this open cartridge fork actually performs very well, and I don't actually have anything to complain about on the front forks. If there is one problem that I have with the bike, and this is my biggest complaint, it's the limited amount that the handlebars can turn. Now, this is due to how high the radiators are mounted in the frame, and so you can only turn the handlebars so far until your forks come in contact with the radiator, and it doesn't give you as much turning distance as a lot of the other bikes, basically any of the other bikes that I've ever ridden. What that does is this means that this bike is a little bit harder to ride in switchbacks and some of the technical terrain when you really want to pull the bars really hard to one side or the other. If you're doing a full lock turn, it's very difficult to do it on this bike because it doesn't turn as tight. It can be as much as 3.5 feet of a wider arc than some of the other bikes out there, which is a downer for me. However, this is not something that every rider is going to come in contact with. If you're just doing the faster stuff, the more flowing stuff, and if the trails never really get that tight with super tight switchbacks, you're never going to notice it. Even if you're just a woods rider, you're probably never going to come in contact with that. But here in the Rocky Mountains, my riding has gotten slower and slower and more technical, and this becomes a limitation for me. It is the only limitation on the bike that I think is worthy of talking about. Everything else on the bike is near dynamite. So then naturally a question we have to answer is, who is this bike for? And my answer is just about anyone. This bike can put a smile on just about anyone's face. This bike is not just a beginner bike, and this bike is not just an expert bike, and that's the thing that makes this thing unique. This is a bike that can be enjoyed by riders of a wide, wide variety in a way that is unique to this bike. Say if you have a Honda CRF 250 X or something, the advanced rider probably isn't gonna wanna ride that. A beginner can ride it and it's a great bike, but the advanced rider isn't gonna have a lot of fun on that. That's the funny thing about this bike, is this bike can be ridden by a brand new first time rider and they'll have a lot of fun and they'll have a lot of confidence and they'll have a lot of headroom to grow. But it can also be ridden by the seasoned veteran. And it's not just a bike that they're gonna go out there and be like, oh, I'm not gonna have fun on. Every single time I've ridden this bike, I've had a ton of fun. I'm not saying that I'm a seasoned vet, but what I'm saying is I am I'm an above average rider, and I've had a freaking blast riding this bike. And every minute that I've been on it, I'm like, huh, that was fun, that was fun, that was fun, and it keeps surprising me. So that's something that's unique to this bike, is it can cover a very wide diversity of riders, and they can have a ton of fun doing it. I like the fact that I have handles on the rear fender that I can grab. I don't like them. I wish that they had the integrated handles on the top of the fender before like they did. This is an underneath style handle that is actually part of the cowling, but it is better than nothing, so that's a nice thing. I like that I can remove the seat with no tools, with just a push button, and get into here. I like that I can put my oil in the bike under the seat. I prefer having the oil here as opposed to anywhere else on the bike. I like having the map switch up here, not on the handlebars. I haven't used the map switch a lot because I love the way the power works on this bike. So I never really got into using, you know, kind of the off power map switch, but I like that it's down out of the way. I don't like a ton of things to be up on the handlebars, up on the controls, which is one problem with this bike. I don't like the fact that it has a horn and all these controls over here. So I like that they moved the map switch for the engine characteristics down here by the fuel tank, so it's out of the way and it's easy to tell which one it's on because it's got lights one way or the other. I'm not a fan of the tires that come stock on these Beta bikes, so I ended up swapping them out with something that I'm more comfortable with pretty much right off the bat. Right now, this one is running a Dunlop AT81 EX gummy tire because that is the most fun tire that I can imagine right now. I get better hookup, but the stock tires that come on these bikes, that is not my favorite part of them, and I end up swapping them pretty quickly as soon as I can. Quick side note here, these bikes do not come with a rear disc guard. This was an aftermarket product that I had to add on. So just don't think that your Beta bike is gonna come standard with this. You could get it with the BYOB program, the Build Your Own Beta program, which is a really, really cool option. So with Beta, you can basically special order your own bike and put a ton of different options on there, of which this is one of the things I think that you could add in the BYOB program. Wanna know something cool? This Beta is actually standing up on its own on the kickstand. That's something that didn't always happen in years past. Beta has put a wider foot on that kickstand to make it so it actually holds the bike up in a lot of places. I think the kickstand is a little bit short because the bike tends to lean over, even though this is a hill and it's actually, it's going up this hill, but the bike is still leaned over quite far. So I think the kickstand is maybe just a little bit short. They might have given us like an extra half inch on that thing so the bike stands up a little straighter and doesn't, you know, increase the force of it pushing down, because I have had, even this wider foot pad, I have had the bike tip over and break my lever. In fact, the only reason my lever is broke right now is because it tipped over into a rock when it was on the kickstand. But it is an improved kickstand from the things that we've had in the past from Beta. It didn't take me very long to break the fender. One loop out on this bike, one ghost ride up a rock face. And because all of this is very stiff and quite brittle plastic, I did break the rear fender and I broke the taillight assembly right here. So that is something that is probably going to happen to you the very first time you loop the bike over. I would like, and that's just one of the things of having this extra cowling here with the license plate holder and the taillight. It makes this whole section back here a little bit more rigid, and that tends to break things off. I prefer having a bike that doesn't have a taillight and this section of the bike being a little bit more you know, flimsy, floppy, so that it doesn't just snap the first time I loop the bike out. But that's what we have here. Just not a complaint, just something to note that you might have a problem with on your Beta. One other thing is none of the graphics are injection molded. They're all basically stick-on vinyl on the top of things, and that can make it so some of those graphics might wear off a little bit quicker where you have the high rub points with between your boots and your body and your knees and things. So I wish that the graphics were injection molded, but I know this is probably just a cost thing and they're trying to keep things down. Up here on the headlight, we actually have a stock headlight that has a high beam and a low beam. And as far as headlights go, this one isn't bad. I love the fact that it's high and low. That's not something that you get with some of the other bikes. And this is serviceable. You could ride this bike at night without having any other auxiliary lighting. I do think it's important if you're gonna do a long ride at night, you might wanna have a helmet mounted light to augment this, but this is one of the better stock headlights, if not the best stock headlight that I've used on a bike. I dump bikes down pretty hard a lot of times, and one day that I dumped this bike down, I did really smash the radiators pretty good on this left-hand side one day, and I think that's because there's not a lot of bracing there on the radiators. I know a lot of bikes don't have bracing there, but the way that this is designed with the radiator shrouds and things, and the stock mud guard on this offers no structural stability at all, and so I did bend this really quite badly. There are aftermarket radiator braces that you can get, and if you were going to do hard enduro style stuff with this bike, you might want to have a radiator brace. I think some of the other bikes out there in the industry, it's not as critical, but this one I think radiator bracing would be a little bit more critical than a lot of the other ones. In conclusion, I want to thank Beta USA for lending me this bike to do this review. This is not a paid review, but it helps everyone because Beta gives me the bike. I then give it back to the dealer. The dealer turns around and sells it as a used bike, so it's a win-win for everyone. I want to thank Beta for doing that. I wholeheartedly recommend these bikes. I've now gone out and bought my very first Beta. They've lent three of them to me in the past, and now I've turned around and I've bought one of my very own because these are quality bikes made by a quality company. So that's what I've got for you guys. If you want to support Dirt Bike Channel, you can go over to Patreon and you can leave a monthly tip amount. You can also use the links down in the description. Anytime you're shopping on Amazon, check to see if I have a link for it, or I have a general link for Amazon as well. Every once in a while, we do dirt bike giveaways, and during those giveaways, I'm selling gear and merch, and that enters you in to win a dirt bike, and it also helps to support my family. Over on my website, I also have links where you can just do a monthly subscription tip amount on PayPal. That helps out a ton, because PayPal doesn't take nearly as much off the top as Patreon does. The only problem is that it's a little harder for me to communicate with you over PayPal. But I really want to thank everyone who sticks with me and watches these videos this far. You are a true Dirt Bike Channel fan if you've watched this far into the video. And remember, wherever you go, let's leave a single track.